Hello and welcome to the series of our guideline videos for healthcare professionals. In the second part of this video regarding Australian Medical Council, AMC, and Professional and Linguistic Assessment Board, PLAB exam for UK, which has recently changed to United Kingdom Medical Licensing Assessment, UKMLA, or MLA exam. We are going to have an in-depth comparative review regarding these two exams' content, passing criteria, how and when to register, as well as attempts allowed to pass these two exams. In the first part, we have already covered more details regarding general overview as well as eligibility criteria for AMC and PLAB or UKMLA exam. Do not forget to watch this first part of the series of videos. We have provided the link here as well as in the description section. This is Dr. Muhammad from Interface Medical Education, and I will try to discuss AMC and PLAB medical licensing exams in a comparative manner. So keep watching this video till the end. I am sure that you will be able to understand many things related to AMC and PLAB exam. Before starting this video, we would also like to invite you to watch many of our videos made for healthcare professionals. I will request you guys to subscribe to our channel, hit the bell icon, to enjoy more of such informative videos in future, and of course, if you like this video then, do not hesitate to hit the like button and send us your valuable comments. So, let's get started now. Let's take the AMC exam first. It consists of two parts. AMC 1, which is a computer adaptive test, CAT exam, which means that in this test environment, each test taker may be given a different set of questions based upon the ability or how well a test taker is performing. AMC CAT exam contains 150 clinical-based MCQs, which are multiple choice questions, delivered in a single 3.5 hour session via Pearson VUE testing service worldwide. Each MCQ has 5 answer choices, and you will be required to choose the one correct choice. 120 MCQs will count towards your passing score, whereas remaining 30 MCQs do not count towards your actual score. Although you should complete all available MCQs, especially these 120 scored MCQs, you will have most of the questions from medicine part with 35 MCQs, followed by surgery topic with 25 MCQs, 15 MCQs from OBS and Gynae, 15 from PEDS, 15 from Mental Health, and 15 from Population Health MCQs, making it a total 120 scoring MCQs. AMC Part 2 is an OSCE-based exam, evaluating a candidate's decision-making, knowledge, and clinical skills for different medical situations. This exam contains total 16 stations. You will be required to go to each station. Out of these 16, 10 stations are graded, and you will have 10 minutes for each station. On the other hand, PLAB is also quite similar to AMC as far as exam content and parts are concerned. Although, despite the PLAB transition to UKMLA, as we discussed in the earlier part of this video, PLAB 1 will be changed with MLA, AKT, which is a Medical Licensing Assessment Applied Knowledge Test. This is a written assessment of applied clinical knowledge, quite similar to the PLAB 1 exam. It is a computer-based multiple-choice question-based exam composed of single best answer, SBA questions. This will be the same for UK graduates and IMGs. The total number of questions ranges from 150 to 200, each having 5 answer choices, labelled A to E. These questions may include images, electrocardiograms, and x-rays, and will be spread across 2 papers, like approximately 100 questions for each paper, covering various areas of clinical practice. PLAB 2 exam has been changed to CPSA, which stands for Clinical and Professional Skills Assessment. This is an OSCE-based exam quite similar to PLAB 2. After passing the AKT exam, you will be required to pass CPSA within 2 years, and once you pass CPSA, then you will be eligible for GMC full registration, enabling you to practice in UK with full license. The CPSA will be similar to the current PLAB 2 exam, where you typically have 16 stations, with 8 minutes allotted time for each station. During these stations, you will be examining and interacting with patients, and then answering questions in single best answer format. It is all about testing your medical knowledge in a more practical environment. the passing criteria and passing ratio for AMC and PLAB or UKMLA exam varies a lot based upon the candidate's performance or ability during these exams. For AMC 1, your score is measured on an adaptive scale of 0 to 500, where a passing score is typically represented on the scale at 250. This exam has about 50% passing rate for IMGs. After successfully passing the AMC CAT examination, you may enroll in AMC Clinical Examination, which is AMC Part 2. During this OSC E-based exam, you will be presented 16 total stations, 2 are pilot stations, and your overall result will be determined by these 14 scored stations. The result will be graded as either pass or fail. To pass this exam, you must score 10 or more during these scoring stations. Candidates scoring 9 or below will be considered as failing. It is only about a 30% passing rate, as many of the IMGs are not able to make it in their first attempt. For the PLAB 1 or UKMLA, AKT exam is also a pass or fail exam. You will be provided a score after the AKT exam, but no passing marks have been provided until now. The passing rate for AKT exam is likely to be tougher than the PLAB one. Therefore, we may see a shrinking passing rate which currently ranges from 60 to 70%. PLAB Part 2 or CPSA exam, which features your clinical history taking, patient examination and clinical skills, assessing your performance during the scored stations, quite similar to PLAB Part 2 exams, where a passing rate is about 40 to 50% for IMGs. Although there isn't a set of passing marks related to scored stations, GMC uses borderline regression scoring method based upon the difficulty level of each station. However, to pass Part 2 or CPSA exam, you must meet or exceed the total required score and pass a minimum of 10 stations overall. You will be required to meet some common and different requirements to be able to register for AMC and PLAB or UKMLA exam. To apply for the AMC and PLAB or UKMLA exam, you must have a medical degree and completed 1 year of uninterrupted internship or house job from your country of graduation, especially for IMGs. It's unlike the USMLE exam, where you can apply for your steps during your graduation. You can apply for these exams online. For AMC exam registration, you are required to complete certain steps to complete an application for an assessment pathway, like authenticating your medical degree, creating Epic and AMC account, and establishing AMC portfolio. We have discussed these steps in detail in one of our guideline videos. We have provided the link in the description section. For AMC CAT MCQs exams available dates, you can find more details at AMC official website. We have provided this link in the description section. Once you have successfully passed the AMC CAT exam, you can enroll for AMC Part 2 exam, which is only physically conducted in Melbourne, but currently you can also schedule AMC 2 exam online. To register for PLAB 1 or AKT exam, you may be required to wait for about 8 months or more, although it is conducted in the months of February, May, August and November. If the exam venue is not available in your country, then you will be required to travel to the country of your choice where the exam venue is available. Whereas PLAB 2 or OSCE exam only takes place in the GMC's Clinical Assessment Centre in Manchester for IMGs. Passing your AMC or PLAB exam in the first attempt is like a dream come true, especially for international medical graduate, IMGs. If you fail, although you have multiple attempts allowed for each of these exams, even the thought of going for a second attempt is itself stressful. Especially for PLAB 1 or UKMLA, AKT exam, where registering for exam is itself a cumbersome task and may take 8 to 12 months of your precious time for just waiting. For PLAB 1 or AKT exam, you have a maximum of 4 attempts allowed, and after 4 failed attempts you may apply for the final 5th attempt, provided that you demonstrate evidence for additional learning to improve your medical knowledge and clinical skills for over 12 months period. As far as PLAB 2 or CPSA, clinical examination is concerned, you can only apply for this exam after successfully passing your PLAB 1 or AKT exam, and you must pass it within 2 years of the date you passed PLAB 1 or AKT exam. Additionally, you must ensure that you meet English proficiency exams requirements. If you have already availed more than 4 attempts for either part of PLAB or UKMLA, then you are no longer eligible to apply for PLAB. When we talk about AMC exam available attempts, although there are unlimited attempts allowed for AMC 1 and 2 exams, provided that you meet all eligibility requirements while applying for the next attempt. But because of the cost factor of this exam, as discussed earlier in this video, your second or third attempt may take too much of your thoughts. That's all from us for this part of the video. In the next last part of this series, we will be exploring important information for AMC and PLAB or UKMLA exams, like an in-depth comparative review for required English proficiency exams, total expenses that may take place on AMC and PLAB, available job opportunities, as well as expected salary structure that you may earn in UK or Australia. You may find the links of all these parts in the description section. Hopefully this video will be beneficial for you and may have clarified many of your questions related to many key points for AMC and PLAB or UKMLA exams, especially before relocating to Australia or UK. Do not forget to watch many of our videos made for healthcare professionals. Hopefully you may have liked this video then. Do not forget to hit the like button. Share, comment and subscribe to our channel. Have a good day, bye.